India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the field of science and technology, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Among the most distinctive features of India are its rivers, which hold immense religious importance in the lives of 1.3 billion denizens. They are considered as goddesses in the country and are worshipped by most of Hindus. Every year, several festivals are also organized in the name of rivers. Ganga Dashehra, celebrated along the banks of River Ganges, is one among these occasions that was recently observed with huge fervor and devotion.
A wave of spirituality swept across the ghats of holy city of Varanasi as scores of devotees thronged the banks of sacred Ganges River to celebrate the festival of Ganga Dashehra with huge devotion and gaiety. They took holy dip in River Ganges to seek blessings and cleanse their sins by bathing and performing rituals on the auspicious occasion. Every year, Ganga Dashehra or Ganga Avtaran is celebrated on the 10th day of the bright half of the moon in the month of Jyeshtha as per the Hindu calendar that marks the descent of the holy river on earth. Regarded as a celestial river originating in the heavens, the legend holds that Ganga was gifted to mankind in response to the great penance undertaken by King Bhagirath, after whom she is also called Bhagirathi. Bhagirath, a descendant of the legendary Sagar dynasty, prayed for Ganges to descend onto the parched earth and bring life.
आज गंगा दशहरा का पर्व है। गंगा दशहरा का पर्व पृथ्वी पर गंगा जी के अवतरण का दिवस है। आज ही के दिन पृथ्वी पर गंगा जी आई थी।
Prayagraj city of Uttar Pradesh also witnessed similar scenes where thousands of devotees flocked to Sangam, the confluence of three sacred rivers, Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati, which is one of the most pious places to observe Ganga Dashehra and take a dip in the river Ganges. Besides, various rites and rituals of Ganga Puja were also performed to appease the goddess Ganga. It is believed that if devotees offer prayers and take a dip in sacred river on this day, they get relieved from all types of sins and attain salvation.
आज जो है दशहरा का दिन है, दशहरा के दिन गंगा स्नान का पर्व माना जाता है, तो लोग ये हिंदू धर्म का एक बहुत मुख्य पर्व होता है। इसके लिए लोग आते हैं गंगा दशहरा, गंगा जी के नहाने, अपने आप को शुद्धिकरण के लिए, अपने मन की शांति के लिए, तन की शांति के लिए, और ईश्वर का ध्यान लगाने के लिए आते हैं लोग।
Ganga River is not only the holy river, but it is the heart of India and a symbol of integrity, cultural unity and the oneness of our nation. Besides serving as one of India's holiest rivers, its cultural and spiritual significance transcends the boundaries of the basin. Ganga Dashehra is a festival by which people express their gratitude to this holy river that has been serving them since generations.
Bringing people of different faiths and communities together at one platform, blood donation camp can be regarded as the noblest way to strengthen national integration and religious harmony along with promoting a noble cause. Taking cue from it, a blood donation camp with the message of communal harmony was recently organized in the Ahmedabad city of Gujarat. Take a look. Erasing the barriers of castes and communities, blood donation provides an opportunity to create harmony in the society, as neither the donor is aware of the caste and community of the recipient, nor the recipient is aware of donors. Walking on the same trail, a blood donation camp was recently organized
in the Daryapur area of Gujarat's Ahmedabad district, whose theme was centered around communal harmony. Organized together by the residents of the area, along with the Ahmedabad City Police, the event brought to light the age-old principles of our country that teach us to have compassion towards all, no matter which faith one belongs to.
बहुत बढ़िया माहौल है इसमें हिंदू मुस्लिम और अभी थोड़ी देर के बाद सिख और क्रिश्चियन लोग भी आ रहे हैं तो सब कम्युनिटी के लोग एक साथ खून कोई एक का खून का कोई एक रंग नहीं होता है हर एक का खून खून होता है तो इस बेसिस पे कम्युनल हार्मनी के आधार पर ये बहुत सौहार्दपूर्ण वातावरण में कैंप चल रहा है
ड्यूरिंग दिस यूनिक ब्लड डोनेशन कैंप People from different communities not just came forward to donate their blood, but also interacted with each other with lot of warmth. With no feelings of bias or hatred, they were seen mingling with each other as if belonging to the same family, promoting the concept of love and brotherhood.
जो हिंदू मुस्लिम एकता का मैसेज देना चाहता है कि हिंदू मुस्लिम एकता सब एक है ब्लड के अंदर किसी का फेरफार नहीं है उसके हिसाब से आज इंसानों ने यहाँ पे सब लोगों ने मिलकर जो है ब्लड डोनेशन किया और यहाँ पर जो है एक मिसाल दी कि हिंदू मुस्लिम एक है उसकी मिसाल देकर यहाँ पर लोगों को समझाया
मैसेज सिर्फ एक ही है हिंदू और मुस्लिम सब एक है ब्लड का रंग सबका एक ही होता है उसमें कोई भेदभाव होना नहीं चाहिए और ये बहुत ही अच्छा काम है
Indians for long have been known for contributing towards such noble causes by rising above religious lines. There, these attempts not just reinforce our faith in communal harmony, but also plays a vital role in strengthening the social fabric of our country.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
A man in Chennai city of Tamil Nadu has adopted more than 45 HIV-positive children who were abandoned by their families. Solomon Raj juggles three jobs to take care of his kids, a grueling task especially when the kids are more vulnerable and face severe health complications due to their condition. The children, all aged between 3 and 20, fondly call him Appa, meaning father. Raj has made sure to provide an education to all the children at the shelter where the children, along with him and his family, are put up.
We did not have children. So I was thinking of adopting a child. Then I was thinking if we want to adopt a child and give life to somebody, they should be very deserving. So I didn't want to go baby shopping and try to find out a child. So I wanted to adopt a HIV child. But then what happened after a few years, we had our biological children. But that guilt of not adopting a child was haunting me all the time. So then when an opportunity came, I started adopting one child.
Raj says that the most challenging task of taking care of the children is when one of them passes away due to complications. He says that it is an emotionally draining task to come back from the hospital and inform the other kids of the situation. Through the years, Solomon has managed to find some good Samaritans and well-wishers who donate and help to take care of the children. Indian lyricist Javed Akhtar recently launched a book in Mumbai city of Maharashtra that tells the story of a victim of domestic violence who transforms into a survivor. So What, written by Indian author Sonal Sonkavde, is a story about the protagonist Pari, who after achieving her dreams is subjected to domestic violence, desertion and faces a dichotomy of thoughts on whether to walk out of a troubled marriage or to let go. The book deals with her dilemma and the idea that what best can happen when a woman is left alone.
So what is all about Paris' journey from turmoil to transformation, from turbulence to trophies? So what, in so what, Pari is a victim, and it's a journey of Pari as a victim to survivor.
Akhtar was also accompanied by Son Kavde during the event, where both posed for media persons. Akhtar said the fact that the book was written by a lady, about a lady, attracted him the most. The world's highest post office, located at a height of 14,567 feet in Lahul and Spiti district of Himachal Pradesh, has turned out to be a tourist hotspot, with people from different parts of the country reaching the place. Being the highest post office on the earth, the tourists coming to the place have a sense of achievement on reaching, and they often buy stamps as souvenirs.
हम वर्ल्ड के सबसे ऊंचे पोस्ट ऑफिस पर है हिकिम में ये अराउंड 15,000 फीट पे लोकेटेड है एक्सपीरियंस की माने तो ये बहुत बड़ा एक्सपीरियंस है कमिंग फ्रॉम मुंबई एकदम 40 डिग्री सेल्सियस से हम -17-18 पर रह चुके सो ओवरऑल एक्सपीरियंस माने तो बहुत बढ़िया हो चुका है
लोकेटेड इन द हिकिम विलेज द पोस्ट ऑफिस केम इनटू बीइंग इन 1983 With a low network connectivity in the area, the small post office connects the villages in the area to the rest of the country. However, due to the heavy snowfall during winters, post office usually remains shut. Postmaster Rinchen Chering has been carrying out the operations from the post office since its establishment to deliver letters to other towns of the state from where they are taken to their assigned destinations.
The state of Jammu and Kashmir recently got soaked in a wave of spiritualism as the state's Gandharbal district hosted the annual Mata Khir Bhavani Fair. One of the biggest religious events of Kashmiri Pandits, its celebration not just limits itself to one community but is open for all, making it a perfect example of communal harmony.
No matter what religion we follow, we are one family. These words, showcasing India's strong bond of secularism, resonated loudly at the Khir Bhavani temple located in Tulmula village of Jammu and Kashmir's Gandharbal district. Housing the shrine of Ragnya Devi, a revered goddess of Kashmiri Pandits, the temple is the holiest destination for the community, who visit it mostly during the annual festival that starts from the day of Jyeshthashtami. Though it is a big occasion for Kashmiri Pandits, people from all communities do eagerly take part in it, setting a beautiful example of peace and brotherhood. Be it doing the arrangements for the annual event, accommodating the Hindu devotees or setting small stalls at Khir Bhavani temple, selling religious offerings or paying their obeisance to the goddess, people from all faiths take part in each and every activity.
आज जो यहाँ पर माहौल हमें ऐसा लग रहा है 30 साल में हमने कभी नहीं देखा हम कंटिन्यू यहाँ पर आते रहते हैं मगर जो जो यहाँ के मुस्लिम बरादरी है इन्होंने जो भाई पजारा रखा है इन्होंने जो घर में तैयारी किया है इन्होंने एकोमोडेशन रखा है और बाकी जो यहाँ पर पूजा का सामान मिलता है इन बेचारों ने रखा इससे हमें ये लग रहा है कि एक नया कश्मीर बन रहा है पंडितों और मुस्लिमों की बरादरी फिर से आ रही है
20 साल हो गए मुझे ये जो यहाँ पंडित बरादरी का ये मेला लगता है खीर भवानी का हमारे ही डिस्ट्रिक्ट में है मैं 20 साल से यहाँ आ रहा हूँ और 20 साल से मैं देख रहा हूँ जो जोश और खरोश यहाँ होता है हर एक कम्युनिटी का चाहे उसमें कोई भी मजहब का अपने अकीदा रखने वाले हैं सब यहाँ शिरकत करते हैं वो इसलिए कि ये जो सूफी संत की वादी है ये जो हमारा यहाँ मतलब आपस में भाईचारा था ये यहां इजहार होता है
द This year, nearly 6,000 to 10,000 displaced pandits from various parts of India and abroad attended the Khir Bhavani fair. By offering rose petals and kheer, a rice pudding to the sacred spring, they paid their obeisance to the goddess, whose temple is constructed just in the middle of the spring, which according to a legend, was earlier surrounded by 360 springs. Along with paying their tribute to the goddess, devotees, especially males, also took a holy dip in the stream close to the shrine. It is only during the occasion of Khir Bhavani fair that the pandits from faraway places visit this temple. But for the entire year, it's the Muslims of the area who take care of it and make sure that the tradition is kept alive.
यहाँ काफी देर से हमारा भाईचारा कायम रहा है, जिस वक्त आज 10-20 साल के वहाँ पंडित काम आते थे इस खीर भवानी में, और जो थोड़े से पंडित होते थे और मुसलमान मिलकर इस खीर भवानी का जो त्यौहार है, हमने परापरम चलाकर इसको पूरी तरह चलाया। आज हमारा भाईचारा दूर दूर से, जो हमारे कश्मीरी माइग्रेंट कोई दिल्ली में है, कोई बॉम्बे में है, कोई जम्मू में है, वो आज सब यहाँ आए हैं और मुसलमान भाईचारे के पास रहे, रात को रहे। जितने भी लोग आए हैं, चाहे वो सोपर था, चाहे वो बारामूला था, चाहे वो नंदनाग था, उनके घरों में रहे और सुबह खीर भवानी में आए, ये हमारा सदियों से भाईचारा है और एकता है।
Today, the festival has turned out to be the most shining example of communal harmony and brotherhood in the country, and very well presents the Sufi culture of the state that binds people of different faith and communities together.
Connecting the younger generation with the rich history of Sikhism, one of the youngest of the major world religions, a Sikh museum has recently been opened in Chhattisgarh's capital city of Raipur. Exhibiting the Sikh culture and tradition, the museum has been drawing several eyeballs since its opening. Take a look.
Located in the Guru Nanak Nagar of Raipur city, Sri Guru Tegh Bahadur Sikh Museum stands as a testimony to the glorious history of Sikhs. Built in the honor of 9th Sikh Guru, Sri Guru Tegh Bahadur, the museum is spread across 5,000 square feet. It enlightens visitors about the 10 Sikh Gurus and other personalities related to Sikhism, the world's fifth largest organized religion that originated in the Punjab region of India around the end of 15th century. Inaugurated in the first week of June, the museum aims to make the younger generation aware about the history of Sikhism.
इस म्यूजियम की खासियत तो सभी कुछ है, लेकिन नौजवान पीढ़ी या जो न्यू जनरेशन है, बच्चे हैं, वो हमारे जो सिख का गौरवशाली इतिहास है, तो उससे वो जुड़ें, उससे वो कनेक्ट करें, क्योंकि बहुत सी सिख पर्सनैलिटीज़ ऐसी हैं जो बच्चों को उसके बारे में जानकारी नहीं मिल पाती। मेन गुरुओं के बारे में या जो ज़्यादा फेमस पर्सनैलिटीज़ हैं उनके बारे में तो उनको जानकारी मिल जाती है, लेकिन बहुत से ऐसे हैं जिनके बारे में जानकारी बच्चों को मिलना बहुत ही ज़रूरी है, तो उसी हिसाब से इसको बनवाया गया है।
The museum contains the replica of a golden temple, which is beautifully showcased inside a glass case. It also has a library where visitors can read books on Sikhism and about Sikh gurus, and home theatre where they can comfortably sit and watch the history of religion through films.
ਵਜ਼ੀਰ ਖਾਨ ਦੇ ਦਿਨ ਹੁਣ ਗਿਣਤੀ ਦੇ ਰਹਿ ਗਏ ਨੇ ਹੁਣ ਤਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਚੈਨ ਮਿਲੇਗਾ ਉਹ ਜੀ ਕਰਦਾ ਸਲੰਦ ਨੂੰ ਅੱਗ ਲਾ ਦਈਏ ਮਲੇਰ ਹੋਟਲ ਦੇ
Along with this, museum has 7-3 portraits of Sikh gurus, which were made by an artist from Jabalpur city of Madhya Pradesh, Sardar Raghubir Singh. The information regarding the portrait is also scribbled underneath.
ਸ਼੍ਰੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਤੇਗ ਬਹਾਦਰ ਜੀ ਸਿੱਖ ਮਿਊਜ਼ੀਅਮ ਬਣਿਆ ਹੈ, ਉਸ ਨੂੰ ਵੇਖਣ ਆਏ ਹੈ। ਜਿਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਅੱਛੀਆਂ ਅੱਛੀਆਂ ਤਸਵੀਰਾਂ ਸਾਡੇ ਸਿੱਖ ਇਤਿਹਾਸ ਨਾਲ ਰਿਲੇਟਡ ਤਸਵੀਰਾਂ, ਸਾਡੇ ਜੋ ਸਿੱਖ ਇਤਿਹਾਸ ਦੇ ਸ਼ਹੀਦ ਸਿੰਘ ਹੋਏ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਰਿਲੇਟਡ ਤਸਵੀਰਾਂ ਜੋ ਅਸੀਂ ਦੇਖੀਆਂ, ਸਾਨੂੰ ਬਹੁਤ ਵਧੀਆ ਲੱਗਿਆ ਹੈ। ਅਤੇ ਪੰਜਾਬ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਹਰ, ਜਾਣੀ ਕਿ ਜਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਪੰਜਾਬ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਹਰ ਹੈ ਛੱਤੀਸਗੜ੍ਹ, ਇਹ ਏਰੀਆ ਹੈ ਜਾਣੀ ਕਿ ਮੱਧ, ਜਾਣੀ ਕਿ ਭਾਰਤ ਜਿਸ ਨੂੰ ਕਹਿ ਰਹੇ ਹਾਂ, ਕਿ ਉਸ ਵਿੱਚ ਜੋ ਇਹ ਮਿਊਜ਼ੀਅਮ ਬਣਿਆ ਹੈ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਸੋਹਣਾ ਬਣਿਆ ਹੈ। ਜਿਸ ਜਾਣੀ ਕਿ ਮੈਂ ਸਮੂਹ ਸੰਗਤਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਬੇਨਤੀ ਕਰਦਾ ਹਾਂ ਕਿ ਜੋ ਛੱਤੀਸਗੜ੍ਹ 'ਚ ਵੀ ਰਹਿੰਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ ਜਾਂ ਬਾਹਰ ਵੀ ਰਹਿੰਦੀਆਂ ਨੇ ਕਿ ਇੱਥੇ ਆਓ, ਇਸ ਮਿਊਜ਼ੀਅਮ ਨੂੰ ਵੇਖੋ ਅਤੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਨਾਲ ਲਿਆਓ, ਤਾਂ ਜੋ ਸਾਡੇ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਪਤਾ ਲੱਗੇ ਜੋ ਸਾਡਾ ਸਿੱਖ ਇਤਿਹਾਸ ਹੈ।
With such museums established across India will not just help in preserving the history of Sikhism but also satisfy the hunger of people who want to explore more about the religion.
A picture is a poem without words. This quote by Horace truly encapsulates that painting is a form of expression that is beyond words. There are so many alphabetical languages that have been devolved so far, but none of those could match the strength of visual language. Depicting the same power of visual art, a 5-day-long painting exhibition was organized in Siliguri district of West Bengal to provide the budding artists with a platform to showcase their talent.
In a bid to provide potential artists with a platform to display their talent and to draw the attention of common people towards art, a 5-day-long painting exhibition cum sale was organized at Ramkinkar Hall in Siliguri district of West Bengal. The exhibition featured 100 spectacular ancient Indian as well as modern era paintings depicting the Indian culture and lifestyle on canvas. Various mature and immature artists, including child artists, participated in the exhibition from various corners of the country.
ये legend artist और medium artist सब लेके 100 painting है इधर में। इसमें दिल्ली से 4 artist आए हैं, कलकत्ता से 8 और सिलीगुड़ी से 8 होगा ऐसा, पूरा 23 आर्टिस्ट और चाइल्ड आर्टिस्ट भी कुछ है, वो 25 आर्टिस्ट है साथ में। हम लोग को मकसद है जो हम लोग सारा इंडिया में जो पोर आर्टिस्ट हैं, जो एग्जीबिशन में आना चाहते हैं लेकिन पैसा के लिए आ नहीं पाते हैं, उन लोग को प्रोवाइड करते हैं हम लोग। हाँ, कुछ थोड़ा नॉमिनल कुछ प्राइस दे के और हम लोग साथ में अपना कुछ योगदान देके ये हम लोग करते हैं। इसमें सफलता भी आया, नए नए आर्टिस्ट भी उभर के आए हैं, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा वर्कशॉप सेमिनार रिसेप करके उनको भी और इम्प्रूव करने की हम लोग कोशिश करते हैं।
The exhibition included a variety of art forms portraying the diverse and distinct culture of our nation. All the paintings were made with a different vision, thus making it a visual treat for the art enthusiasts of the city. Audience, mesmerized by the magnificent paintings, appreciated the efforts of all the artists and claimed to have a good experience.
सारी तस्वीरें अच्छे हैं। यह से बाहर से बहुत लोग आए हैं यहाँ पे। हम एग्जीबिशन देखकर बहुत खुश हुआ। तरह तरह के तस्वीर है यहाँ से, बड़े भी है छोटे भी है, सभी का काम बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है।
आर्ट इज द लैंग्वेज ऑफ सोल दैट एनेबल्स पीपल टू एक्सप्रेस थिंग्स दैट कांट बी एक्सप्रेस्ड इन वर्ड्स। Such step taken by various organizations not only provide the artists with a space to showcase their talent, but also give them a chance to narrate various stories through vivid and colorful murals.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at suggest.myindia@gmail.com. I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.